Blessed and happy Thursday to all of you, my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, my dear good people of God, faithful followers of the Daily Gospel Reflection with Father Jack, my dear kababayans. Today, September 12, 2024, Thursday, within the 23rd week in Ordinary Time, Year B. Our Gospel for today is from the beautiful and the wonderful account of the Gospel of Luke, chapter 6, verses 27 to 38. Forgiveness is never easy. Loving an enemy is so contrary to human nature. Human nature is like this, an eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. Today, Jesus is teaching us the best approach to forgiven enemies. Three ways. One, first, love them. Love your enemies. Second, do good to those who hate you. And third, pray for those who abuse you. Love your enemies because love has a transformative power. Love is an effective agent of change. The secret to forgive is love. Love is the password of forgiveness. The more you love, the easier it will be to forgive. And take note, it is difficult to forgive if pride is the name of your best friend. Pride will make you a beast, not best. You need to love, we need to love our enemies, because love is the weakness of the devil. The more we love, the more the devil hates us. If you choose to love, the devil will melt like snow. Friends, choose to love. And second, do good to those who hate you. Do the opposite of your haters. If they strike you on the cheek, take no revenge. Offer the other side also, says the Lord. If they curse you, bless them. If they mistreat you, be kind to them. We need to remove this virus called hatred and violence in our life. Starve violence by being a peacemaker. And remember this and take note of this. Not to forgive is just like drinking a poison and expecting others to die. And finally, love. We need to, if we do good, let us not remember or do not remember the records of your good works. As what the saying says, write it on the water. Do good without expecting anything in return. Do good and more good will come to you. Friends, do not expect in return from an enemy, but allow God to reward you. And that's my point. I say it again. Do not expect in return from an enemy of the good works you have done, but allow God to reward you. Because when God will reward you, it will be good measure, it will be pressed down, shaken together, and running over. In Tagalog, we say it, siksik, liglig, at umaapaw na biyaya. When God will reward us, it will be an overflowing in abundance. If you love and like this reflection, kindly share it with your friends, share it with your family, make the word of God viral so that many will be blessed.